I'm here to show you how to connect with your provider using a MyChart video visit. You may have scheduled a video visit appointment, requested a video visit on demand, or your provider may have transitioned a previously scheduled in-person appointment into a video visit. In any case, the basic steps I'm about to show will be similar. Keep in mind that there might be differences between healthcare providers, including whether video visits are offered. Always trust the instructions you receive from your care team when seeking virtual care. I'll show you how to connect to a video visit using the mobile app, but the steps on the website will be the same. Let's say you have a video visit scheduled for today. It will appear in your health feed. Based on your visit type, the appointment may require e-check-in. You may be able to pay any outstanding balances, like a copay or previous balance. I'll pay the copay. After entering or verifying your credit card information, the payment will be processed right away. You may also have the opportunity to update your current medications. I'll add ibuprofen. And select a pharmacy where I will get my prescriptions filled. Next, you'll likely be asked a series of questions required by your healthcare provider. I won't demonstrate answering all of the questions, I'll just show you the first few. Once the questionnaire is complete, you might have to read and sign a consent form. You can sign forms by tapping the box and using your finger for your signature. Now it's time to submit. The information is on file. I'll close e-check-in. You can connect to your video visit before your appointment time to test your equipment. Your provider may use a third-party video conferencing program. Check your video visit instructions to confirm how you should conduct the visit. The Begin Visit button is available. Note that this button may be grayed out until closer to the appointment time. I'll get started. If you are connecting to your video visit using a mobile device, you may be prompted to connect your camera and microphone. Be sure to allow for both. You may wait in the virtual waiting room until your provider connects to the visit. When your provider connects to conduct the visit, they will guide you through the visit just like they would in person. Thanks for watching.